We've been interested in understanding what's called self-healing materials. Self-healing materials are materials which actually mend themselves even when they get broken. For example, if we had this kind of materials in pipes, when there was a leak, they will naturally mend that leak and plug it. The reason why we went to blood in this case, because that's a perfect example of a system in which you get self-healing. Basically, we're bleeding all the time and our organism is self-healing its vessels continuously. The focus of this work has been on the first stages of blood clotting, which, by the way, occurs even in the absence of a lesion. Cells can die, and in that case, they open a little wound, or just normal stresses that you have in your body will actually cause little places to not seal perfectly. And in that case, you need this cascade to start rolling in and plug that leak. There's two principal components that are very important in the first stages of clotting, which are actually the focus of the work that we are presenting here. And they are a polymer, which is a long chain. It's a really long chain. You need this very long polymer, if not you have a disease. It's called von Willebrand factor. And the other key ingredient is something that looks not spherical, but you can think of an object that is about 1/100 the size of a hair, and it's called platelet. And it's a cell, and you have quite a bit of them in your blood. So the idea is that these two objects start to interact with each other. And the way they start to interact is actually regulated by the flow. So essentially, von Willebrand factor can be thought as this scotch tape that under normal conditions, it basically doesn't stick to anything. But suddenly, due to flow and some chemical activations, it will actually stretch. And the moment it's stretched, now you have many different parts of this molecule, which is basically like spaghetti, that can actually stick to other things. It can stick to the surface, but it can also stick to, let's say, platelets that I'm going to think about as this hand. So it can stick here, and because I'm in the flow, this will actually just roll around and it will make a very strong binding. Now, you can repeat that. If this is very long, it can actually stick to one and stick to others, and it will start basically what we call linking different platelets. So that will be the starting point of this aggregate that just keep on growing and growing. And that big aggregate is actually what we call the plug. And we were very interested in this plug formation, meaning the formation of this aggregate of platelets and von Willebrand factor, or this polymer. And the reason was because it behaves in a very counterintuitive way. Most things will tend to break when you have high flows. This actually forms in high flows. Basically, the stronger the flow you put on it, the more propensity it has for aggregating. And this is very counterintuitive, but it's very interesting from the standpoint of self-healing materials. One of the cool surprises that we found in this work was that the aggregation phenomena was universal. And what does that mean? It means that if we think about a few parameters in the system, we could basically describe the behavior of it in terms of one then universal parameter that depended on them. And this allows us to essentially move across multiple different physical systems, because we can now tell you what's going to happen in all of them. We can tell you, for example, when some system is going to dissolve or when some system is going to aggregate, irrespective of, you know, if we're talking of biological system or we're talking about a synthetic system, because it all comes down to those parameters that come into the universal features of the system. And this could be very important in when we're actually trying to create materials at the molecular level and controlling their molecular structure in a very precise way.